In a terrifying historical move, one Western nation has become the first to recognize Sharia law in the courtroom after a judge forced an abused wife to do an incredibly disturbing thing. One Western country has become the first to mandate Sharia law after a judge dismissed an abused woman's testimony in accordance with Islam, prompting an international outcry. Stock photos for illustrative purposes, credit, screenshot, YouTube, screenshot, YouTube. After the West decided to open its borders to mass migration from Islamic nations, many were strangely surprised when the new arrivals didn't repay their generosity by abandoning their own ideological compulsions for the host's tolerant values. Despite 1,400 years of history showcasing Islam's determination to conquer the West by any means necessary, Europeans ignorantly believed that our culture of diversity and progress could magically change a millennium of deeply ingrained hardline religious conformity, proving that it only takes a tiny, steadily expanding minority of Muslims to fundamentally transform a nation. Sweden has taken the lead in Europe to become the first country to recognize Sharia law in its courtrooms. At just below 10%, Sweden's Muslim populace already has the justice system by the throat, which could not be more apparent after one court's decision to flagrantly flout Swedish democracy in favor of a common Sharia punishment for an obvious victim. In February 2018, the Solna District Court ruled that although a woman was found to have been repeatedly beaten by her Iraqi Muslim husband, her testimony would be thrown out in favor of the abuser because his family has a good reputation while hers does not, making her less trustworthy than her husband, according to Aftonbladet. Causing an international outcry, the court suggested that because the man came from a good family, the wife should have gone to her husband's relatives in order to work out her abuse instead of filing charges against him. In one of the most shocking rulings to come out of Sweden, the court explained that because the woman didn't consult her husband's family for advice before going to the police over her alleged abuse, she lost credibility in court, convincing two lay judges to side with the offender. The court also determined that the woman should have settled the dispute with her husband's family because the pair married under Sharia law, completely dismissing Swedish law and citing that this is the standard procedure under Islamic law. It's normal in these circles that a woman tells the family that she is being beaten so that the matter can be resolved within the family. The fact that NN, the woman, did not tell her husband's relatives that he hit her, but instead reported it to the police, further reduces her credibility, the judgment states. Expressin confirmed that the court stated that the woman should have turned to her husband's Iraqi migrant family and not the police if she was being beaten because Sharia law requires such steps. Subsequently, the Iraqi man was cleared of all charges and his wife was forced to return home to her alleged abuser. Sweden's Solna District Court lay judge Attisa Maldeby Pictured ruled that the woman's testimony lost credibility because she went to the police instead of her husband's family after suffering spousal abuse. Photo credit, screenshot, YouTube. One of the two lay judges is Attisa Maldeby, a female Muslim justice who openly advocates for the recognition of Sharia law in Sweden. Maldeby is part of Sweden's Liberal Centre Party, which has even come forward to denounce her ruling as is and a clear replacement of Swedish law with Sharia law. As such, the left-leaning party has demanded that Maldeby withdraw her membership. The kind of ISK reasoning that arises in the judgment is completely unacceptable. Such sweeping and prejudicial allegations against women, in whatever context they are completely contrary to the values of the Centre Party. If you stand behind the judgment given in the ruling, you cannot to be a member nominated by the Centre Party, said Magnus Persson, leader of Solna's Centre Party. Maldeby is one of the lay judges who participated in convincing Stockholm's administrative court to reject asylum applications of at least three Christian converts who were in danger of being executed under Sharia law for leaving Islam. Still, Maldeby maintains that her judgments have nothing to do with her advocacy for and personal following of Sharia law. I've ruled in many cases. I've ruled in favor of men in some cases and in favor of women in others. In this case, I followed the law. Swedish law, Attisa Maldeby argued in her defense. Maldeby understands that Sharia law isn't the empowering feminist movement that Western Muslims claim it to be. In fact, according to the Quran, a woman's worth is not only half that of a man's. Wentworth. Her testimony in court is merely a fraction of her male counterparts, regardless of evidence. Of course, it wouldn't matter even if a woman could produce the required male witnesses to make her testimony valid in the case of domestic abuse, as the Quran also commands that men are in charge of women and should beat them if they fear disobedience from the wives. Alderby is showing Sweden and its liberals that, despite their embrace and tolerance, Islam cannot coexist with any other religion or law. It has come to the West in order to eradicate man-made law and establish Sharia. Until there is no more disbelief in the religion, all of it is for Allah, just as the Quran explicitly commands. Follow us on Facebook, Gab.